The world has seen better days, but we've come to the end of March all the same. Today we've compiled Ahrefs updates from the past couple of months for you. Let's get to them. We have two tool updates for you and three general updates. Let's start with Site Explorer. We've beefed up Overview 2.0 a little. If you look at the stats block, you'll see a new section for paid keywords and pages. And in the history chart below, we now show both organic traffic value and paid traffic cost. You can click on these metrics to toggle them on and off in the chart itself. Moving on to the next Site Explorer update. We've launched our new site structure report. At the time of recording this video, this report is only available for agency accounts. But once we roll out our new pricing structure, this will be available if you're on a new advanced plan or higher. With site structure, you can see any website structure in a tree format without having to crawl it. On top of that, you'll see some top-level metrics for each path. Use this report to quickly analyze the sections of a website that are driving the most organic traffic, referring domains, or paid traffic metrics. You can also see changes over a specific time period and customize the report for your needs. Next up, we've launched a new paid keywords report. Like with all new reports, you can use this date picker to compare changes between two dates. On top of that, we've improved the filters to help you sort through your data, such as these position and keyword filters, which previously weren't available in Site Explorer 1.0. And that's not all. We have three new features for you. First up is this handy new mini chart that shows the distribution of paid versus organic clicks. For example, here, we can see that Monday is advertising for their brand name, monday.com. And if we hover over the chart, you see that 56% of clicks come from paid and 43% from organic. You can also add keywords directly to Rank Tracker and Keywords Explorer lists by clicking on this plus icon next to them. Finally, we've added a new history chart for ads positions. Click on this hamburger icon to see which landing pages were advertised for a keyword in the past, and how that's changed over time. This helps you to understand the PPC competition for that keyword. And if you hover over these bars, you'll also see actual ad copy at each point in time. This lets you track how the ad itself changed over time. Next up, Keywords Explorer. You've added the same ads positions history chart in Keywords Explorer itself. Just enter your keyword and scroll down to see it. Moving on, we have two general updates. First up, keyword database updates. Last year, we invested a lot of time and resources on improving our keyword data. A quick summary, we refined our search volume numbers by blending data from multiple sources and finding the right balance between them. We also improved our database update frequency and introduced monthly search volume values for each keyword, with an option to export them into CSV. We wrote a blog post that goes into a lot more detail. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. This March, we added 500 million new keywords across all countries, with around 40 million in the US alone. Monthly search volume trends are now available until January 22. Moving on to our next update. If you open your alerts and head over to mentions, you'll see some handy new filters: domain rating, website traffic, word count, and exclude subdomains. Play around with these to really fine-tune your tracking of web mentions for queries relevant to your business. On to our last update. We are finally ready to publicly announce the Ahrefs WordPress plugin. With this plugin, you'll be able to automate your content audits and grow organic traffic to your WordPress website. What the plugin does is regularly audit your blog and show you how each article performs for a chosen target keyword based on Ahrefs, GA, and GSE data. Then it suggests what you can do to improve their performance. Go download it and give it a try. We have a blog post on how to install the plugin and run your first audit. I'll leave that in the video description below as well. And that's it for our March updates. Let me know if you liked anything in particular this month, or if there's anything else we can do to make our tools better for you. And as always, subscribe to this channel for more product updates, tutorials, use cases, and me. See you in the next update. Bye!